Hey, this is Kev with Blender Binge, back with another video for you. So this time we're going to be creating this groovy disco ball. First thing we're going to do is we're going to get rid of our cube. Sorry, cube. And then I'm just going to set up my camera. So to do that, I'm going to hit my camera and I'm going to hit Alt G to center it and Alt R to drop the rotation. Next thing I'm gonna do is I'm just gonna rotate it up. So I'm gonna hit N on the keyboard or hit this little arrow. And I'm going to go to rotation and I'm gonna say 90 degrees. And now I have my camera pointing this way. And then what I'm gonna do is I'm just going to hit the move tool so I can just hit shift space bar, hit move or just G, grab, whatever, whichever you like, I don't care. They both work and pull that back. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to add in our disco ball. So to do that, I'm going to just going to go to add or hit shift A. And I'm going to go to UV sphere, hit UV sphere. And I'm going to go to my properties for UV sphere down here. And I'm just going to change segments here to 40 and rings to 20. And that's going to look about, it's going to look pretty good for what we want. Good. So now if I hit zero, you can see I have a disco ball here. And I need to pull the camera out a little bit more. So to do that, I'm just going to hit lock camera to view, and I'm gonna use my scroll wheel and just pull out a little bit. And then I can turn off lock camera to view. And now I have set up a kind of disco ball-y thing. So if I go here to Eevee, right, to rendered view, and we're gonna use Eevee for this, you can see that I have this ball set up with a light. So I don't like the light, I'm gonna get rid of it. So I'm gonna right click on light, I'm gonna hit delete, gone. Now, here's where the fun starts happening. I'm just gonna turn on bloom, and I'll turn on screen space reflections, and I'll turn off half res trace, because it annoys me. You could leave it on if your computer's slower, that's totally fine. I won't judge you. And I don't need refraction, so I'm gonna leave that off. Okay, so cool, right? Now what we're gonna do is we're gonna shade it. Now I'm getting tired of using this little look dev area up here. I don't know why, I just don't. So I'm gonna go old school here, and I'm gonna go here, move my mouse where it pluses, pull it up, and I'm gonna change this to shader editor. And now in shader editor, I'm just gonna have my ball selected. So I'm just gonna go sphere. I'm gonna call this disco ball, because why not? It's our disco ball. And I'm gonna hit new. And right now it is set on my principled shader. So I'm gonna go to metallic, whack that all the way up. Roughness, I'm gonna turn down, but I'm gonna leave a little bit on. And we still see a whole heck of a lot of nothing. So I'm gonna give it a world. Here is where the magic happens. Yeah, I know I said that like 2 minutes ago, but this is really where the magic happens. So I'm gonna go to object, I'm gonna go to world. And now it says background. I'm just gonna go ahead into background and I'm gonna add in a Musgrave texture. So I'm gonna go add, I'm gonna go to texture and I'm gonna say Musgrave texture, color to color, and there we go. So now I have something to reflect. And now we see the disco ball. Ooh, pretty cool, right? So it's like, it's reflecting the environment, right? I turn the strength up and all of a sudden, boom, we got like Studio 50 something. So cool, right? Okay, but it's kind of boring. So what I'm gonna do with that is I'm going to put a ramp in between Musgrave texture and background, and that's gonna let me add in all sorts of cool trippy colors to this. So to do that, I'm just gonna go to add, or you can hit shift A. I don't care what you do, either one works fine. Go to converter, color ramp, and we're gonna drop the color ramp over this little line. Okay, line's white, means we can click on it, it drops it, it wires it, everything's cool, I'm happy. Now I'm gonna change from linear here to constant, and we have constant white and constant black. And it gives us these trippy, trippiness, right? So I'm gonna go ahead and add more colors in here. A cool little shortcut is holding down control and clicking in this black area, and you could add more little arrows. And these little tick marks here, little arrow things, let you put color in. So let's say first color, let's just say, I don't know, I'll put in like red. And my second color, I'll put in yellow. And my black color here, third color, I'll put in blue. And yeah, maybe I'll leave white. I'll put white toward the end. I don't know. That's kind of just an ugly color. I don't know. That looks like puke. I'm going to do something about that. Turn that up a little bit. There we go. That's cool. That's better. All right. Less vomit, more pre-vomit. Because, you know, it's a disco. You're going to party and maybe vomit. So, there we go, right? I dig that. So, now we're going to add that cool trippy thing that was around this guy. Right? So, you know what? Let's just go and animate this now, just so you can see what it does. Because, like, I'm a fan of the quick win, and you want to see something cool right now, right? I mean, this wasn't cool enough. Let's go and add something really cool. So what we're going to do is, I'm going to say, let's figure out where we want to rotate it. What rotation? I think it's going to be around the Z. That's my guess. I was correct. So what I'm going to do is at frame one down here, and I'm going to make this really big so you can see it, because, you know, it's a video. You're supposed to see stuff, right? I'm going to go to Z, rotation, right click, and hit single keyframe, insert single keyframe. And then I get these little diamond things. Then I'm going to go out here to 250, because I'm just not going to change this. I'm just going to leave it at 250. It's fine with me. I'm going to go to Z, and I'm going to say 359. Okay, not quite a full rotation, 359, because it's going to loop. Right click, say insert single keyframe. And now you can see here that if I hit play, it doesn't pause. You don't see it pausing. You're just kind of mesmerized by all these dancing disco ball-y stuff. And as it gets to the end here, you're going to see it does not pause. All right? Maybe somebody will say, yeah, you know, it does. Technically, it's wrong, but it just go with it. Make it look good. Okay? Now, what I'm going to do is I'm going to add all that cool, trippy thing around here. So to do that, I think I'm just going to go to Shift-A or Add, either one. Say mesh, and I'm going to say a cylinder. And now I just need to rotate the cylinder around the X. So rotate around the X, and I'm going to just type in 90 degrees because I know it's 90 degrees. I'm going to scale this thing up, hit S, scale it up, pull it past the camera so you're like inside it, and there we go. So what I'll do now is I'm on cylinder, right? So I'm just gonna call this like trippy thingy. And I'm gonna give it the same shader as our disco ball. So to do that, I need to go back out of world. Let me shrink this. Out of world, I need to go back to object. And I'm just going to, trippy thingy is selected. I'm not gonna hit new. I'm just gonna drop this down. I'm gonna say material 001. That's the one I gave it. And as you can see here, we now have the same thing. But you don't really see much. So what we're going to do with this is, okay, lock camera to viewers off so I can switch around. And there we go. So there's our mirror thingy. And he's perfectly enclosed in the mirror thingy. So what I'll do is I'm going to hit tab. And I'm going to get rid of the face. This front face. Don't need it. Don't want it. Delete. Gone. Now I'll hit zero again to go back in here, and I can select the back just by clicking on it. Now I'm going to hit S, and I'm going to pull it down so it goes behind our sphere. And now I get this trippy mirror effect. Pretty cool, right? And now what I can do is I can hit Control 1. Actually, no. Let me get out of that first. Scratch that. Hit Tab. Get out of that. Now you can hit Control 1, and that gives it a subdivision surface. So if you go to trippy thingy and you go to the modifiers, you see it has a subdivision modifier on it, and it has a view of one, render of two. You want these to be the same, or when you render, it's going to look different. So one is fine. If I go view two, it looks all right. I don't know. I'll leave it at that. And now I'll just put a light behind it so it breaks it up. So to do that, I'm just going to go add or shift A. I'm going to say light, and I'm going to say point. And it goes inside there, and it's not doing us any good. So I'm going to go to point, and I'll go location, and I'll just put it back on the Y. Oops, that's in front. Oh, I don't want that. Put it back here. And whoa! There we go. So now it's behind it. And it's hitting that mirror thingy, and it's lighting it up. So I can make the color, I don't know, put it out toward blue. Everybody seems to like this combination. I'll go with it. Probably make my thumbnail more clickable or something, I don't know. And I can play with that now. So I don't have to have it at 10 watts. That's kind of crazy. I mean, I could have it at like 3, and that does what I need. And now if I move this, you'll see it just kind of gives me these, ooh, look, heart shapes. Cool, right? Heart shapes, disco, peace, love, disco, right? Okay, cool. So I got these heart shapes. So what I'll do here is I'll click on trippy thingy and I'll rotate them. So I think I'm going to rotate this guy around the Y axis. Yep. All right. So let me scale this up for you so you can see it again. I'm just going to go to the Y axis here. I'm on frame one. Make sure you're on frame one. Y, right click, insert single keyframe, then left click, drag out here to 250, 359, enter, right click, insert single keyframe, and now I hit play, and we have crazy disco inferno stuff. Travolta, Scientology, yeah, no, they come after you. Okay, so check this out. I'm going to go to... let me see here. Bloom. Okay, so I go here to the little camera, back of the camera thing, go to bloom, and I can up the threshold a bit so it's not so bloomy. Let's see. I can actually go crazy here. Like, I can go like 1, and then I can take the threshold up to like... that's too much. Not doing that. 10 is fine. Pull the intensity down. Intensity a little bit. All right, radius I could take down a little bit and just kind of get it glowing. And each scene is going to be a little bit different. So you probably just want to play with it, play with the radius, play with everything until it fits for your scene. If you followed exactly what I did, you probably get exactly what I'm getting right now. But feel free to play around. All right, I don't need to clamp it. And you can play with the color too and make it more trippy, less trippy, more saturated, less saturated, whatever. I don't care. It's up to you. And to go to render it, we're simply just going to go to output. I'll say output here. I'm going to name it. Oh, I go to disco ball, tutorial.mp4, because we're going to render it out as an MP4 for now. All right. Normally, I would like composite this and do a whole bunch of cool stuff with it, but just for the sake of this video and getting it done in a short time, I'm just going to do that. All right, so I'm going to go here to PNG. That is obviously not PNG. We want FFmpeg. That's good. Encoding, I'm going to change that to H.264 in MP4. All right, that gives us what we want. 1920 by 1080, that's pretty good. I think we're okay. I think we got everything we want. Render that, those samples are fine for here. One last thing is make sure subdivisions are set. Okay, render matches this, or you're going to get something that looks different than that. And now I go to render, and we'll come back and check it out. And we're back. And here's our animation disco ball tutorial, right? Animation that we made. All right, so that was a little hot. So what we could do here is I could go back to world, and I can play with the world a little bit. And these hearts are kind of cool, but I can also push that out. So I can take this and push this guy, push these out a little bit into here. Get these like spiky things. Or I could just animate this. That might be pretty cool. Let's do that. Let's animate this. So what I can do is go 2, 1, and I'll go ahead and let's say on the Y, insert single keyframe, and I'll say maybe 48 frames. I could push them out. So now that happens. And a cool thing here that you can loop this. So to do that, it's really easy. Just going to go here, change this to graph editor. And for graph editor here, all I'm gonna do is I'm gonna go to channel, extrapolation mode, and I'm going to hit make cyclic. There. Now watch this. And it's gonna keep doing that all the way until the end. Except it loops now. Take this, pull it in till it's about, we want that to be right about there. So it starts at the same spot. There we go. So now it kind of loops. With all this other stuff going on, it's not going to be too crazy. Let's check it out. There we go. So I'll go ahead and render this and come back. Okay, so here we are back again, and this is our final render, and it's looking pretty cool, pretty wild and trippy and fun, and, you know, it'd be great on a big DJ screen for 5 minutes or 10 minutes until your whole audience gets a seizure, and it could be pretty cool. So hopefully you enjoyed this tutorial. If you did, hit like, subscribe, share it, do it, just make it, and just go be awesome, and I'll just keep doing more. Thanks. Talk to you later. Bye.